This one from Black Forex Traders. So I'm back with another YouTube video. So in this video I'll be showing you how to scalp or trade smaller time frame like 5 minutes using order blocks. So today I'll be showing you that. So I'll be making this this series of order blocks in parts. So now I'm just doing the first part, which is how to trade order blocks on smaller time frame, usually 5 minutes, even 1 minute time frame. So I'm gonna use 5 minutes time frame, then I'm gonna show you how I do it in 5 minutes time frame. So the first thing is to understand the market structure. So if the market is moving like this, then you know that you're looking for bullish order blocks. So in this case, let's say your order block is here. I mean, in this case your order block maybe somewhere in the middle here. So you're looking for what? For the break of structure of the new high highs that they create. So this will be the high they break, then also this will be the high that they break, and also this will be the high that they break. So as long as they are creating a higher highs and higher lows, you're looking for bullish order blocks. So there'll come a time where they will do something like this. Sorry, let me connect the charger. They'll do something like this. Then immediately, as you see them breaking the previous low, in this case this will be our low here, starting to break the previous low like this, then you know that the market is changing direction. So you start looking forward for bearish order blocks. So you'll see they will be starting to make something like this, breaking the lower lows, catching the lower high, something like this. So in this case you can see that they start to break this new lower lows that they create. But before you see all of this, they have to take the previous new higher low that they just created, which will be this one here. So once they start to break this low, you know that the market is trying to do what? To push down. Then you start looking for bearish order blocks. So this is the market structure, and this is what I'm going to be talking about today. So I'm just going to give you a few examples, then that will be for today, for today's video. Then on the next video, then I'm gonna keep explaining more and more about order blocks. So as you can see, as I explained, on the uptrend we're looking for what? For bullish order blocks, I mean. And then on a downtrend you're looking for what? For bearish order block. So if you want to trade smaller time frame, let's say 5 minutes time frame, you must start by looking at 15 minutes time frame. So if you are 15 minutes time frame and your 5 minutes time frame order blocks they correspond, then that's more like a strong level for you in order to put in pending orders or to sell when the market reaches that level, right? So at least even to trade 1 minute time frame, at least 5 minutes time frame and 1 minute time frame, they must correspond with an order block. So that way it will be more confidence and it will give you more assurance that there's a high chance that the market can reverse at this point. So that's how I use it. If I want to trade small time frame like 15 minutes, I will look for my order block on on 15 minutes time frame, and then go to smaller time frame just to adjust my lines on 5 minutes so that I can get an accurate entry. So let me just give you a few examples. Okay, let's look at this one here. Okay, this is 5 minutes time frame. If you go to 1 hour, so you can see the one thing that I was talking about the market structure here. You can see that here we had an uptrend, right? We had an uptrend, the market is in an uptrend, then meaning that you will be looking for what? For bullish order blocks only, right? So you can see that at this point the order block that is very visible is this one here, right? You can see that here they created a swing low, which is this low, and a swing high here. Then your order block would be the last bearish can stick before the break of structure. So in this case, at this 15 minutes, this level here will be your order block, like this. So once the market reaches this point, you can see that the first attempt was this one here. So that's why I usually tell people, if you are trading order blocks, put your stop loss 5 pips away from what, from the order block level here. So if your entry is here, put your stop loss below. Don't put it approximately at the level of your order block. Put it below. So in this case, if you put it here, they won't hit your stop loss, then they will just test here, then they go up. Then so after that, you can see that the market did what? They broke the previous low, which is this level here. Then once you they start to do that, you start looking for what? For bearish order blocks, right? Then let's go to 5 minutes time frame. You can see on 5 minutes time frame, this will be our previous low, this level here, right? This will be our previous low. Then you can see that it was what? It was broken here. It was our break of structure here. So this candlestick broke the previous low, meaning that you start looking for what? For bearish order block. So your bearish order block in this case will be what? The last bullish candlestick. So we'll use this candlestick here as our order block here. Meaning that this is where we're gonna wait for the market to come, and then we're gonna sell. So as you can see, the market target came to this target here, then they touched this level, which is our order block, and then they went down, right? To create a new low, then a new high again, right? Then they went up. So the same thing again, the break of structure here. You can see the break of structure, they went down. What is your order block? The last bullish candlestick before the break of structure. So this will be your order block here. This candlestick here. So as you can see, sometimes they won't just come through to your order blocks. You can see this is a missed order block. As you can see, they came close to the order block, but they didn't what? They didn't touch the order block. So this is how you trade the order blocks. So let me find the bullish ones. So let's look at this one here. Let's look at this one here. So this will be our previous lower high, which will be this one here, right? Which is our swing high. Then this will be our swing low here, right? Then this is where the break of structure happens here. Then from there, this is our break of structure. This candlestick here, it broke out, then it closed here, then they reversed. So your order block will be the last bearish candlestick before the reversal. So before the break of structure here. So this will be your order block here. So you can see that this order block was imperfect here. So it did what? It got broken here. So meaning that if you had your pinning orders here, then your stop loss here, then you can see that sometimes the market will just what? Hit your stop loss and then they reverse. So if you had a pinning order, they hit them here. You can see this candlestick here. It shows the momentum. Once it closes here, you take another entry. This will be your second entry point here. Like this. This will be your second entry point. So this will be your first order block here, right? Then from there, you can see they start to create a new high, which is this one here. This is our swing high. Then this is our swing low. Then you can see this is the break of structure here. Right? Then the order block is the last bearish candlestick, which will be this one here. This will be our order block here. So you can see they came close to the order block. They tested on the order block. Then they did what? They went up. So if you had your pending orders or your ticket manually, this will be your trade. So this will be your trade. You stop loss at least 5 pips away from the order block level. So it will be like this. As you can see, they went up. So the only thing you gotta do is to wait until they break the previous low. Let me see. So as you can see, they went up. This is where they broke the previous low here. So remember, the last order block will be this one here. So as you can see, this movement here, they didn't break this previous low here. They went up to create an uptrend, then they give you the double bottom here. They give you the double bottom here, then they give you what? The break of structure here. This will be a break of structure. As you can see, they created the higher high, then the higher low, the higher high. Then this is where they did what? They broke the previous low, which is this one here. Then this will be your order block here. as I explained earlier. So this will be your order block. Then from there, you start looking for what? For sell order blocks until you see them doing what? Starting to break the higher highs. So as long as you can see now that the market is consolidating, which is something that I don't like, this kind of movement here. So I don't trade this kind of movement here. So as you can see, I started from where? From 15 minutes time frame here, right? I got the break of structure here. This is the break of structure. Then from here, after the getting the break of structure, you can see that I went through smaller time frame to find my accurate order block. Because if I was using only 15 minutes, then this movement here, this candlestick, will be what? My order block. But I wanted the sniper entry, then on 5 minutes, you can see that it give you what the sniper entry like this. Then if you had your pending orders here, to just click them, boom, they went down. Then they make another break of structure here, the lower low. Then this is the failed one, which they didn't come close to the order block. So this is how I trade on 5 minutes time frame and even on 1 minute time frame. Let me give you an example of today's trade, which is Nasdaq. I took Nasdaq on 1 minute time frame today. Okay, let me go to 1 minute time frame. I want to show you the trade that I took today. If you can remember where it is. Okay, this was my order block here. This trade here. Because I had what? The break of structure here. So if you are on social on my social media, you will see that I shared this trade here. You can see this was my order block. Then my stop loss, I think it was somewhere around here. Yeah, somewhere around here, they didn't hit my stop loss, they just came close to my stop loss, then they did what? They went down, and this is where I closed the trade. This is where I closed the trade. So this is the order block on 1 minute time frame, which if you go through 15 minutes, you can see that the order block is where? On 15 minutes, this is the break of structure, your order block is here, giving you what? The sniper entry. Right, but if you want the early entry, that's why I went to smaller time frame to 15 minutes. Then I used this break of structure movement here. I used the last bullish candlestick. That's why I followed the rules to use this last movement here. That's why I said my entry was here in the middle. I think I put it here, 50% of the order block, which is here, which is the sniper entry also. Then that's why they did what? They didn't hit my stop loss, which was above the order block line, then they went down. So I hope this helps you guys. This is what I wanted to share with you if you want to trade smaller time frame using order blocks. So thank you guys. I will see you on the next video, which is the part 2 of this one here. Then I'm going to be getting into depth on how to trade order blocks on higher time frame and so on. So it's going to be a lot of parts, because I don't want to make a long video, so I just want to make them short so that you can enjoy them and be able to do other things. So thank you guys. If you haven't subscribed, please subscribe to my YouTube channel and also like this video. Thank you.